Hello children, today I am going to teach you the lesson Gautam Buddha. So take out your social studies book and open page number 91. But before starting the chapter Gautam Buddha, first you should know who was Gautam Buddha, right? So I am going to tell you one story about Buddha. Okay, listen the story carefully, children. There was a boy named Siddharth Gautama. He was born in Nepal. His mother's name was Maya Devi and father was King Suddhodana. He was a king of Kapilavastu. When Siddharth was only 7 days old, his mother died. Okay, so his father brought him up in a very peaceful and nice way. But after his birth, an astrologer predicted that if Gautam stayed inside his palace his whole life, then he would become a great king. But if he left the palace, then he would become a saint. Here, astrologer means what, children? Astrologer is a person who tells our future, right? And predicted means who tells. He predicted that Siddharth will become a saint if he will leave his palace. Palace, kings live in a palace, right? So his father decided, he got scared. Whose father? Siddharth Gautama's father got scared, that so that he did not allow Siddharth to leave his palace. Siddharth was inclined towards meditation. He was interesting. He was interested in meditation. But his father tried to keep him from the harsh realities of the world so that he will not go outside the palace. He kept Siddharth inside the palace all the time. Okay. But when Siddharth Gautam turned 16, his father found a woman for him to marry. See? Here Siddharth Gautama is getting married with a woman whose name was Yasodhara. Okay, they had a son named Rahul. Okay, but after some days, Siddharth Gautama was not feeling okay. He was not feeling happy. Though he had everything as a king's son, but he was not happy. Because why he was not happy? Because he wanted to learn about life which is outside the palace. That means outside his home. Okay. As the time passes, his curiosity grew with age. Okay. Curiosity, he was getting excited what is going outside his palace. Okay. So one day what happened? He asked his charioteer to take him to the tour to the city. Against his father, he went to the tour. What happened? The first person they met was an old man. They met means Siddharth. Siddharth Gautama went with his charioteer. Who is a charioteer? See, chariot is a this. Okay. And the who runs the chariot is a charioteer. Okay, so they met with an old man who seemed weak. The charioteer explained Siddharth that along with age, weakness come. Okay, and failing health also. Then they met with a sick man who was in great pain. Okay, he was suffering from sickness. And finally, what happened? The third person whom Siddharth met was a dead body. That is, Then he was told that everyone will die one day leaving this world. Okay, then he met with a saint. See here, Siddhartha Gautama met with a saint and he told him, whenever you will get the answers of these questions, then you can come to me. Okay, then what happened? When Siddharth returned home, he decided, he was not feeling happy. He decided to leave his home, his family, everything. And at that time, he was only of 29 years old. Okay, to find his inner peace. He was, after meeting that three persons, he was not feeling well. He was not happy inside. So he decided to leave this his palace and everything, his family, to find his inner peace. Okay, then what happened? He went to the forest in search of peace and truth. What is the truth? That he was told one day all will die and all. So he went into the forest in search of peace and truth. He roamed, he went from place to place. For what? To gain knowledge. He met many saints also, but he did not get any answer. He was not satisfied at all. So at last, what happened? At last, after trying different ways to find truth, he finally reached the city of Bodh Gaya. Okay, and he started meditating under a fig tree. Meditation, you know, nowadays all people do. Not only nowadays, before also. See, Gautam Buddha, he is meditating. He started meditating under a fig tree. It's a name of the tree, fig tree. And that this tree is also called the Bodhi tree. Okay, he meditated here for 49 days. Continuously he meditated here under this tree for 49 days. And after that, he got enlightenment. He became enlightened. Who is enlightened person, children? The enlightened person is open-minded. He, after meditation, he became enlightened. Okay, that means he is able to tell which state a person's mind was. Okay, what you are thinking, at what state you are, your mind is. He can see the world with great clarity. Okay, from now onwards only he was called as Buddha. Okay, he got transformed into Buddha, and that time his age was 35 years. Okay, from this age he was known as Gautama Buddha. Okay, so before he was known as, his real name was Siddhartha Gautama, as I told you before. And how did he known as Gautama Buddha? I told you this also. At the age of 35, he got transformed into Buddha. And what did this tree is also known as? Bodh Vriksh. Okay, Bodhi tree or Bodhi Vriksh. Okay, now what happened? Buddha started teaching his knowledge. What he gained till now, he started teaching others also. Okay, he started teaching his knowledge. The teachings which Buddha started giving, it is only known as Buddhism. What he teach, it became one religion, and that is called Buddhism. Okay, he shared his knowledge with five sannyasis. You can see here, five sannyasis are sitting over here. Okay, Buddha shared his knowledge with these five sannyasis who meditated with him. They also started meditated with him and also traveled with him all over the country, teaching what Gautama Buddha told them. Okay, what he shared his knowledge with them, they started teaching these to others, and these teachings are known as noble truth. Okay, and after this, Gautama Buddha was 80 years old, that means at the age of 80 years Gautama Buddha died, and that is he teached 45 years. Okay, he died, and his birthday is still remembered as Buddha Jayanti in India. Buddha Jayanti, we celebrate this day as his birthday. Okay, now children, you come to know the story of Buddha, Gautama Buddha. Now take out your book and we will follow the story. Gautama Buddha was the son of King Suddhodana of Kapilavastu. I told you, Siddhartha Gautama, he was the son of King Suddhodana, and Gautama Buddha was born in Nepal. Gautama Buddha was a very noble and kind-hearted boy. He was very kind. He never fought with anyone. He only likes peace, and he was very kind. He always liked to meditate. Okay, as I told you in the story, he had a cousin, Devadatta by name. That means his cousin's name was Devadatta. Whose cousin was his? Devadatta. Devadatta was a cousin of Gautama Buddha. Both Gautama Buddha and Devadatta used to play together in a garden. That means Gautama Buddha and Devadatta, they were cousins. They used to play in their garden because Gautama Buddha was not allowed to go outside his palace, right? So he always play with him, that is with his cousin Devadatta. Once Buddha was sitting near a pond. Buddha was sitting near a pond. He was watching the swans in the water. What he was doing near a pond? He was sitting near a pond, and what was he doing? He was watching the swans. Okay, all of a sudden a swan fell at his feet. What happened? All of a sudden swan fell at his feet. Swan fell down. Why he fell down? There was an arrow in its body. Who saw that arrow in its body? Gautama Buddha saw an arrow in swan's body. That time, as soon as he saw, Buddha felt very pity on it. That means he was kind hearted, so he felt very pity on swan that he was bleeding because arrow was in its body. That's why swan was bleeding. He picked up the swan in his arms and drew the arrow out of the wound. And what happened after that? He picked the swan in his arms. And what he did? He drew the arrow, that arrow, from his body slowly and slowly. He dressed its wound, that is, he cured its wound and patted it. Within no time, what happened? What do you mean by patted? Children, patted means he gave a gentle stroke on the swan's back. Okay, then what happened? All of a sudden, what happened? Devadatta came running there. Who was Devadatta? I told you, Devadatta was a cousin of Buddha. He came there and he was in a hurry. What he did? He said to Buddha, "It is my swan. give it to me. Devdatta ordered Buddha, give this swan to me. It is my swan. Why he is saying so? It is my swan because Devdatta only shot an arrow in the swan's body. Okay, that's why he was asking Buddha to give that swan to him. But what did Buddha did? But Buddha refused to give. He said, I won't give because I have saved its life. You tried to kill it. Buddha refused. That means Buddha said no, he will not give to Devdatta. Why he refused to give? Because Buddha said Buddha only saved its life. He saved its life. Yes, by how did he save the life of the swan? Buddha saved the life of the swan by drew the arrow out of its body. Yes, and he dressed also its wound. Yes, but what did Devdatta did? He tried to kill that swan. That's why he refused to return the swan to his cousin. They went to the king. Here, who are they? Buddha and Devdatta. They both decided to go to the king. Okay, for justice. Both wanted to have the swan. Because Buddha refused to give, that's why they went to the king for justice. The king gave his judgment in Buddha's favor. What did the king did? The king gave his decision in Buddha's favor. That means the king decided that the swan will be with Buddha. Okay, Gautama Buddha. Because he saved his life, that's why king also gave his judgment in Buddha's favor. Buddha himself was kind and he taught people not to kill men, animals or birds. Buddha was a kind-hearted man. Yes, and he also taught people not to kill any men, animals or birds. His main teachings were, we should not kill others, either it's men or animals or birds. We should love each other. His main teachings were love, peace and pity. Okay, so you understood the chapter. It's very easy. Now it's time to get your homework. So copy it down. First homework is fill in the blanks. Okay, number one, Buddha felt dash on the swan. Number two, Gautam Buddha was the son of a dash. Number three, Buddha taught the people not to kill dash, dash and dash. That means three blanks are here in number three. Number four, Buddha was watching the dash in the water. Number five, Buddha's cousin's name was dash. Okay, children. Second homework is answer in one word. Number one, Buddha's father. Number two, Buddha's save it. That means whom did Buddha save? Number three, he wanted to have swan. You have to write who wanted to have the swan. Number four, his teachings were love, peace and pity. Okay, now you have to do it in your exercise copy and after coming back to school, I will check your homework. Please go through the chapter once again. Learn all the chapters till now. Thank you.